So tunaingia kwenye last part ambayo ni basically ni first law of thermodynamics, lakini tutasoma thermodynamics kama thermodynamics as much as we can. So we will concentrate basically kwenye first law ambayo ndio ya muhimu zaidi as far as this context is concerned, na thermodynamic process tutasoma thermodynamic processes, tutasoma specific capacities of gas, tutasoma work done during thermodynamic process na establishing the first law na applications zake. Tutaona. So what is thermodynamics? Kimsingi, thermodynamics is the branch of physics that deals with the relationship between heat and other forms of energy. In particular, it describes how thermal energy is converted to and from other forms of energy and how it affects matter. So later tutaona the equation. So for such a definition, ukimaliza kudefine unaweka ile equation yetu kwamba Q ni sawasawa na change in U plus work done. So we shall see this. So nitaka kukwazia tu kwamba definition lazima iwe na qualitative part na quantitative part. So it deals with the relationship between heat and other forms of energy, kwamba heat inafanya kazi fulani. Kwa mfano kwenye heat engines, whereby unakuta ni heat inatumika ku drive treni au other forms of energies, kama ambavyo we shall see hapo mbele kidogo. But there are common terms ambazo lazima tuwe na lugha ambayo tukiongea tunaweza tukaelewana. Tukisema a system, they like to ask these questions kwenye mtihani kudefine. So tukisema a system, what do we mean? A system is actually a quantity of matter or a region of space with which is under consideration in analysis of the problem. So tunavyosema a system ni region au quantity of matter ambayo inahusika kwenye consideration ya analysis ya hiyo problem au hilo swali au hiyo context ya thermodynamic process inapokaa. That's what we call a system. Okay. Tunaposema system iko aina mbili, either closed or open. Closed system ni when there is no mass transfer across the system boundary. Kwa kama tuna specify kama sisi system yetu consist of a book and a pen, the closed system ni exclusively ina include tu pen na daftari. So energy transfer might be there but there is no mass transfer across the system beyond the system boundary. While open system is just open for everything can enter and leave. So there may be both matter and energy transfer across the boundary of that system. Tunaposema isolated system, there is neither matter nor energy transfer across the boundary. It is entirely extremely closed. Kwenye closed system, while energy transfer can be there, like with isolated, it's isolated, yani imetengwa, iko peke yake. Nothing leaves, nothing enters. That's what we call isolated system. So the state of the system and the state variables. Okay, these are the state of the system means the conditions of the system. It is described in terms of certain observable properties which are called state variables. For example, temperature, pressure, and volume. Kwa tunavyosema state ya system unaidefine kulingana na hizi state variables. Kwa it is a state of the system means the conditions of the system. Okay, that's what the ni state ya hii system. Okay, pressure ni 2, temperature ni 5 joule, 5 Kelvin, na volume ni 1 meters cubic. So that's the state of the system. So state function, physical quantity is a state function if the change in its value during the process depends only on the current state of the system and does not depend on the path by which the change has been brought about. I love this example. Kwamba chukulia density. Density ni state function. Kwa mfano, it doesn't matter umechukua maji kwenye bomba, umechukua maji kisimani, umechukua maji baharini. As long as yako kwenye the same state, current state, yote ni maji na ni liquid. The same state exactly. Then density itabaki vile vile. So density will only change depending na state ya maji iliyopo sasa hivi. But not the path ambayo ilitumika kutengeneza hayo maji au kuyaleta hayo maji. Does not depend on that. So such case na kwa state function. Kwa static process is the process in which the change in any of the parameters takes place in such a slow speed that the values of P, V, and T can be taken to be practically constant. Kwa ukiambiwa this is a quasi-static process, you know, the system, the process is very slow such that PV na T can be taken to be practically constant. Kuna types of the thermodynamic processes, so we say that the thermodynamic process has occurred when the system changes from one state to another. So there are various types, as we shall see, ya thermodynamic processes kama isobaric, isochoric, and the other types. So we shall go straight to the laws of the thermodynamics. So we have what we call zeroth law. We have the first law, the second law, and the third law. Zeroth law was the law and by the before all these other three laws were discovered. So it was later discovered in the zikaja hizi law nyingine tatu. So zeroth law states that if two bodies are in thermoequilibrium with some third body, when there is also, which is, then they are also in equilibrium with each other. But you have one body, second body, and another third body. Okay? When these two are in equilibrium with this one, these two must be in equilibrium with each other. So it was just a simple logic ambayo zeroth alisema. So this establishes temperature as a fundamental measurable property of matter. Okay? As a fundamental property of matter. So it wasn't that important. Our focus will be in the first law, ambayo in a state that the total increase in energy of that system is equal to the increase in thermal energy plus work done on the system. This states that heat is a form of energy and therefore subject to the principle of conservation. So basically wanamaanisha that the total increase of energy of a system, call it Q, is equal to increase in thermal energy, which is internal energy of a body, change in U, plus work done by that system. One thing I want you to note ni kwamba work done is equal to pressure times change in volume. Okay, pressure times volume ni sawasawa na work done, right? So as far as the thermodynamics is concerned, tutakuwa tunatumia pressure times change in volume. So this law has limitations, okay? First, the first limitation is that the first law does not indicate direction of heat transfer. Okay, it never tells us why heat always transfers from higher temperature to lower temperature. Haijaonyeshi chochote kuhusu transfer. I mean direction ya heat transfer. Natokaje? Nimesema tu kuna changes, yes, and all that story, but haijatuambia direction ya heat transfer huwa inafanyaje. Pili, it does not tell us conditions to convert heat to work. Imesema tu is a form of energy subject to change, but doesn't tell us what are the actual conditions to convert this heat into work. Mbona mawe ambayo yanakuwa juani yamepigwa nje jua, mbona hayaanzi kutembea? Labda tuseme ziko tu converted, labda jiwe liko hapo juani limepigwa na jua, then suddenly unaanza kuona jiwe hilo linaanza kumove kwa sababu ya conversion ya ile heat iliyoipata to mechanical energy. So why it does not happen? So it does not explain that. Kuna conditions gani behind converting heat to work. Third, it cannot tell us why whole heat cannot be converted into mechanical work continuously. Okay? You can not convert heat into mechanical. Mfano heat, unataka utengeneze heat iwe converted to kinetic energy. You cannot do that continuously. Okay? There must be losses in other conversion ambazo haziendi kwenye mechanical energy, zinaenda somewhere else. So there came the second law ambayo ina state heat energy cannot be transferred from a body at a lower temperature to a body at a higher temperature. It was trying to solve some of the limitations of the first law. So it says that heat energy cannot be transferred from a body at a lower temperature to a body at a higher temperature without an addition of energy. So it can't just occur spontaneously. Lazima kuwe na addition, extra energy ya nje ambayo inasababisha hiyo transfer ya heat. And this is why it costs money to run an air conditioner. Yes. Ndio maana sio tu kwa sababu kuna air conditioner you think kwamba ukiweka tu inaweza kufanya kazi. There must be an extra energy from outside ya kuran air conditioner. Okay? The third law in a state that entropy of a pure crystal at absolute zero is zero. We shall see the meaning of entropy later. But entropy basically inamaanisha disorder in a system. So we shall see it later in its specific part. So we will move to the first law as far as our context is concerned. Sisi tunadeal na first law. Before we start solving what the laws are telling us, we shall speak of the thermodynamic process whereby these laws zinakuwa applied. So these laws can be applied in different systems. Okay, as you remember, system is a state of system. So there are basically four types of systems. Basically, there are more, but basically in a common system, we have isothermal. Just like how the name itself in a same isothermal, it means thermal is the constant thing. So isothermal process is when the temperature of that system remains constant during a process. So we call it isothermal. So it's a system ambayo temperature is being kept constant. So heat may flow in or out of the system during an isothermal process, e.g. latent heat of vaporization of water is an isothermal process. Yes, kwa sababu you know kwamba tukifika kwenye latent heat ni concealed heat. If you remember the concept za heat kule chini ulipokuwa mdogo ni secondary. Tulisema inaitwa latent kwa sababu kwa mfano unapochemsha maji yanafika 100 degrees centigrade. Then yakishafika 100 degrees centigrade, any extra heat itakuwa ni latent kwa sababu it does not increase the temperature further. Boiling inakuwa ni 100 degrees centigrade, but the extra heat inasababisha tu vaporization. So yanakuwa yana boil at a constant temperature ambayo ni boiling point. Kwa inakuwa ni latent heat of vaporization au latent heat freezing point na all those things. Or those examples, these are examples ambazo ni isothermal processes. So vaporization. Also, if we stretch a rubber band quickly is an example of a isothermal process, okay? Because temperature of that rubber is constant and the process is working that way. Also, when the melting of an ice at 0 degrees is an example of a isothermal process, the same way. The mana inakuwa at zero is in a melt, so temperature inakuwa contained at 0 degrees centigrade. But we have what we call a adiabatic process. Okay, adiabatic process is the process by which no heat can flow into the system, nor from the system. So no heat can flow from the system to the surrounding or vice versa. So you can recall our equation here. This is the heat that can either be lost or gained. And even if it above in our car when your body, either increasing internal energy and work done by that body. So tunavyosema isobaric, it means Q ni sawa na zero. So should get me very, very well. Tunaposema adiabatic process, Q ni sawa sawa na zero. Q ni sawa sawa na zero because no heat is entering or leaving the system. And that Q is the one ambayo inaelezea hiyo heat ambayo it can either be gained or lost. So example for adiabatic process is expansion or contraction of a gas in a cylinder surrounded by an insulating material. Okay? Expansion, contraction of a gas in a cylinder surrounded by an insulating material. So you can just brainstorm kuona, but that is an adiabatic process. Isochoric process, choric volume, okay, is the process during which the volume of the system is kept constant. So isochoric volume inakuwa constant. For example, when you are heating or cooling the contents of a sealed inelastic container, kwamba una container ambayo iko sealed na iko inelastic na una heat mle ndani. So vina increase vingine vyote, but the volume kwa vile ni sealed na inelastic haiwezi ku expand. Ni isochoric volume inakuwa vimebaki pale pale. Also we have isobaric process. Isobar, bar barometer for pressure. So is the process during which the pressure of the system is kept constant. Example, if you have a cylinder with a movable weighted piston and you heat the gas in it. So unai compress ile piston iko na movable weighted piston, so to maintain that pressure ambayo inakuwa exerted kwenye hiyo gas, na unakuwa una heat the gas, so the gas expands due to increase in internal energy, but the pressure kulingana na ile piston ambayo umeifix compress pressure kiasi gani inabaki vile vile. And in summary, we have here other processes. You can see isentheric, isentropic, isobaric, isochoric, but that's not our interest. Our interest is the adiabatic properties held constant is the heat energy. We have isobaric, that is adiabatic, isobaric where pressure is kept constant, isochoric where volume is kept constant, isothermal where temperature is kept constant, and all others are not our interest. And if you were to plot a diagram for the four basic thermodynamic processes, if you plot pressure against volume, if you plot pressure against volume, you shall clearly see kwamba for an isochoric process where volume is kept constant, graph yake inakuwa ni straight line. Straight line because along this, all this volume ni ile ile ambayo itakuwa na so much kilicho chini. So at this point, the same volume, that point, at that point, at that form, the same volume. And isobaric, when you have the same pressure, okay, it's a line perpendicular to that of pressure. So at this point, pressure ni ile ile, at this point, pressure ni ile ile ambayo tunasoma hii ambayo iko hapa. While for isothermal inakuwa somehow different. Isothermal na adiabatic zinakuwa ni curves, but adiabatic inakuwa ni much steeper curve kuliko isothermal process.